India has joined the select group of countries to have designed and built their aircraft carriers. India's first indigenous aircraft carrier, INS Vikrant, has successfully completed a 5-day maiden sea voyage. The Indian Navy said that the system parameters proved satisfactory during the trials. The ship's performance, including hull, main propulsion, power generation and distribution (PGD), and auxiliary equipment were tested during the exercise. This is a major boost for the Indian Navy and Make in India initiative. The carrier is expected to undergo a series of sea trials prior to its delivery to the Indian Navy in 2022. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how worthy is INS Vikrant carrier of the Indian Navy. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. INS Vikrant is 22 meters, that's 860 feet long, and 62 meters, or 203 feet wide, and displaces about 45,000 metric tons. Vikrant is comparable in dimensions to the Indian Navy's current aircraft carrier, INS Vikramaditya, a completely upgraded Kiev-class warship. Vikrant is powered by 4 General Electric LM2500+ gas turbines on 2 shafts, generating over 80 megawatts or 110,000 horsepower of power. It has a speed of 51 kilometers per hour or 32 miles per hour and an endurance of around 13,890 kilometers or 8,630 miles. The total cost of the project is about $3.2 billion. Vikrant has Israeli-supplied MF Star radar that can be used for surface search as well as tracking aerial contacts. The radar is a multifunction, active electronically scanned array (AESA) radar developed by IAI's Alta division. The radar system is made up of 4 active arrays operating in the S-band. Each of the 4 arrays is positioned in one direction. The MF Star is considered to be as powerful as the U.S. Navy's Aegis combat system that uses the ANSPY 1D radar and forms the core of America's most advanced Ticonderoga-class cruisers and Arleigh Burke-class destroyers. The radar can track hundreds of targets simultaneously and is said to be capable of guiding 24 missiles. The MF Star is capable of detecting large aerial targets at distances greater than 300 kilometers or 185 miles and sea-skimming cruise missiles at ranges greater than 25 kilometers or 15.5 miles. The actual values are thought to be much higher and are classified. INS Vikrant features a STOBAR, short takeoff but arrested recovery, configuration with a ski jump. India is yet to finalize the aircraft for the carrier. Currently, the standard Indian Navy carrier fighter is the Russian-made MiG-29K, which operates from the INS Vikramaditya. Depending on the chosen fighter, the carrier is expected to accommodate 20 to 26 aircraft. In late January 2017, the Indian Navy released an International Request for Information (RFI) for 57 multi-role carrier-borne fighters. For Vikrant, it's likely that one of these, Boeing FA-18E&F Super Hornet, DASSAULT Rafale, or the MiG-29K will be selected. In December 2020, Boeing demonstrated FA-18E&F operations from Indian carriers at the shore-based test facility at Naval Air Station Patuxent River in Maryland in the U.S. Since India is impressed with Rafale acquired for its Air Force and swift delivery by France, Rafale M, which is the naval variant, is also a strong contender. MiG-29K has been operated by the Indian Navy already, and hence there's a comfort factor, making it a potential choice. It remains to be seen which one will make the cut. Vikrant will also have a mix of Kamov Ka-31 Helix Airborne Early Warning Helicopters, Ka-28 Helix Anti-Submarine Helicopters, and HAL Chitak Plane Guard and Utility Helicopters. The primary air defense weapon of INS Vikrant is the Barak 8. Barak 8, which has been jointly developed by India and Israel. This 90-kilometer or 56-miles range missile is designed from the start to intercept supersonic cruise missiles, which travel a few meters above the water, which makes it perfect for missile defense. The carrier is expected to have two 32 vertical launch system cells. A very important feature of Barak 8 is that the minimum engagement range is only 0.31 miles, or half a kilometer. So the system can target an incoming hostile object till the very last seconds, potentially giving it the ability to target it multiple times. This enables it to intercept missiles very close to the ship, and it performs the role of point defense SAM as well. The role of CIWS, close-in weapon system, is left to the 4 AK-630 six-barreled 30mm Gatling guns, which is a last-ditch defense against missiles. INS Vikrant is an impressive engineering feat, and with the inclusion of suitable fighters, the carrier will be able to project power from long range. The Indian Navy has been focusing to boost its overall capabilities in view of China's growing attempts to increase its military presence in the Indian Ocean region. The Indian Ocean, considered the backyard of the Indian Navy, is critical to the country's strategic interests. Once the new Vikrant is commissioned into service, India will possess two carriers. INS Vikrant would strengthen India's position in the Indian Ocean region and its quest for a blue water navy. India is planning to have three carriers and work on the next indigenous carrier, INS Vishal, is progressing. The carrier will be bigger and likely to have a displacement of 65,000 tons. INS Vikrant is a good first step.